Very good morning to everyone. In this lecture, CS8601 Mobile Computing. Today we are going to discuss about the topic GPRS. The next step towards more flexible and powerful data transmission, avoid the problems by being the full packet oriented. The GPRS, that is a general packet radio service, provide the packet mode transfer for applications that exhibit the traffic patterns such as frequent transmission of small volume or infrequent transmission of small or medium volume according to the requirement specifications. For the new GPRS radio channels, the GSM system can allocate between 1 and 8 time slot with a TDMA frame. The time slot are not allocated in a fixed and predetermined manner, but on demand all time slot can shared by active user. Up and down link are allocated separately. The allocation of the slot is based on the current load operator preference. The GPRS concept is independent of channel characteristics and of type of channels, and it does not limit the maximum data rate. All GPRS services can be used in parallel to conventional services. The GPRS include the several security services such as authentication, access control, user identity, confidentiality, and user information confidentiality. The GPRS architecture introduced the two new network elements, which are called GPRS support node and are in fact the router. All GSM has an integrated into the standard GSM architectures, and many new interfaces has been defined. The gateway of GPRS support node, it is a interworking unit between the GPRS network and the external packet network, that is a PDN. This node contains the routing information for GPRS users. It performs the address convention and tunnel data to a user wise encapsulation. Now, the other new elements of servicing of GPRS support node in to support the mobile station and also the GPRS registers, it keep track of individual mobile locations. Now we are going to discuss the block diagram of GPRS, that is a GPRS architecture reference model. The packet data is transmitted from the PDN by GSM and GGSM and GSN and SGSN directly to the baseband subsystem and finally to the mobile station. The mobile switching center, which is responsible for data transport in the traditional circuit switched GSM, is only used for signaling in the GPRS scenario. Before sending any data over the GPRS network, and mobile station must attract to it the following procedures of the mobile management. That attachment procedures include the assigning a temporal identifier. It is called the temporal logical link identifier, that is a TLLI. And also the key sequence number of data encryption for each mobile station. A GPRS context is set up and stored in the mobile station and in the corresponding node of the GSM. It attaching and deleting the mobility management allocations for the function of authentication, location management, and also the data forwarding techniques. So the protocols of architecture for the transmission plane of GPRS, all the data within the GPRS backbone between the GSN is transferred using the GPRS tunneling protocols, that is a GTP. The GTP has two different transport protocols, either reliable TCP or non-reliable UDP, that is a user-defined protocols. The network protocols for GPRS backbone is the IP to adapt to different characteristics of underlying network. The subnetwork dependent coverage protocols is used between the GSN and to the mobile station. The user packet data is tunneled from the mobile station to the GSN versus to achieve a high reliability of packet transfer between the signaling of packet switched data and the signaling network in the mobile station. A special automatic request mechanism for the services. Now, the overall goal in this context is provision of the more efficient and the cheaper packet data transfer service for typical internet application that usually relays slowly of packet transfer. The network provides typically support is model for charging on volume and not a connection frame of time as usual for traditional GSM data services and also the HSCSD services. The main benefits of user of GPRS is always on characteristics. No connections have been set up prior to the data transfer. Now we can move to the GPRS concept is independent of channel characteristics and of typical type of channels and does not limit the maximum data rate. All GPRS services can be used in parallel to conventional services and at the beginning only code schemes are available, 1 and 2 available. So we can choosing the code scheme depending on the current error rate, that is a code sequence 1 to 4, the slot 1 to 8. So the code scheme dependent to the slot 1, this is a GPRS data bits in kilobits per second, that is a rate analysis to the slot 1 to slot 8. And it should be noted the reliable real day available data rate heavily depends on the current load of the cell as GPRS typically only uses ideal time slot. The transfer rate depends on the capabilities of the mobile station as not all devices are available to send and receive the same time. The maximum possible number of slot time limited the transfer rate even more. For example, a class 12 device may receive data using 4 slot within the GSM time frame, or it may send the data using the 4 slot. Now we can move to the tables gives the device classes together with their ability to use the time slot for sending and receiving the data in the GPRS. However, a maximum number of 5 slot may be used together. Today, as a typical mobile station is a class 10 devices using class 2, which is result in receiving rate of 53.6 kilobits per second and a signaling rate of 26.k kilobits per second. So this is a examples for GPRS device classes. The classes is a 1 to 12, the receiving slot and sending slot, maximum number of slot is there. So the class is 1, the receiving slot is 1, and also the sending slot is 1, and the maximum number of slot is 2, that is a transmitters and also the receiving point destination. So each individual classes and receiving and sending that slot will be modified to compensate the maximum number of slot in the GPRO system. So the overall session, we are completely discussed the GPRS technology in the mobile communication system. It is one of the packet mode transfer of application exhibit the traffic patterns in the frequent transmission of the small volume and the infrequent transmission of the medium volume according to the requirement of physical specifications. So the data, it can be modified to ready the frame, that is a different type of frame, the data link layer, to create the data frame depending upon the routing and also the transportation layer through the GPRS or GSM. So the GPRS should allow the category of services, that is a three category: broadcast services, multicast services, and also the unicast services, to provide to exchange the information from their source to destination side. Thank you for watching this video.